Welcome back. Modern accelerators, GPUs, AI accelerators, and others are built for massive parallelism. Intel Max GPU, for example, can perform hundreds of thousands of work items in parallel. Think about it as threads executing in parallel. How do we make sure we effectively feed these highly parallel machines? SYCL provides a way to efficiently express parallelism and map concurrent tasks to different processors in your system. Most modern architectures are modular. Let me give you an example using my integrated GPU, Iris Xe LP. The basic building block is an execution unit. The execution unit on my GPU can simultaneously multi-thread 7 threads on multiple data, for example, 8 floating point 32 in parallel. A subslice contains 16 such execution units and some other logic for the subslice, local memory and more. And in my GPU, there are 6 subslices that construct one slice. If you have a stronger GPU, it keeps on building up slices and stacks and so on. And each hierarchy has its own dedicated memory and logic. Now let's talk about the software. This, for example, is a loop. A loop is, by nature, sequential. You execute its iterations one after the other. There's, of course, ways to tell the compiler that there's no dependencies between the iteration, but there's no way it can figure it out during compile time. A lambda function, like this one, was built to run in parallel. We only define the operation done on the data in the red rectangle, and the iteration space is defined here. One iteration is called a work item. The full range is called the global size, described using ND range. Here, we will perform this device code 1024 times. ND range can have up to 3 dimensions, but I'll use only one for simplicity. So we have multiple work items running in parallel on our GPU. Where will each of these work items be executed on the GPU? Work items running on different subslices will have to communicate via the L3 cache. Work items running on the same subslice can communicate via the SLM, a lower level, faster memory hierarchy. Work items running on the same execution unit can communicate via registers. So locality matters, and not only for memory transactions. And this is exactly what we can control with SYCL ND range. Here, I'm just saying run this work item 1,000 times, anywhere you'd like, on any EU. And here, I'm asking it to, again, run this work item 1,000 times, but to bundle each 64 of the work items to run on the same subslice. All the work items in a work group, here 64 of them, will be executed on the same subslice, and the performance implications are high. Let me give you an example. Let's do it together. Open a oneAPI terminal. It comes with a base toolkit installation, and it just initializes oneAPI. Now type SYCL-LS, and you are getting a list of all the devices in the system. Watch my other video on device detection and selection. Device 1 is my CPU, device 2 is my integrated GPU, and device 3 is my discrete Intel Arc A770 GPU. This is a simple example of matrix multiplication, and I'll leave you that code. Look for the link below. I'm accumulating A multiplied by B into C. The overall size, the global size of the matrix, is N by N, and the work group size is M by M. The matrix size is 1024. You can play with it. And let me start with a work group of 1 on my integrated GPU, platform 2, and it takes 32 seconds to complete on my Iris Xe GPU. But I can increase the work size to 256, so let's make it 16 by 16. It's running again, and now it takes only 5 seconds, 6 times faster, just by changing the work group size. Let's do the same for my Arc GPU, platform 3, work group of 1, and it takes 6 seconds. Maximum work group size is 1024, so let's make it 32 by 32, and we're going down to 1 second. As you can see, locality matters, and using work groups is essential for getting most of the performance out of your system. Try it out. Enjoy, subscribe. Thank you.